Tonight, the Salvation Army is asking for your help to reach its annual goal, and it has struggled to get there this year.
Yes, it has. The organization actually sits far below its target right now. Our Jesse Inman joins us now with how it could affect them in 2019. Jesse.
Well, yeah, guys, they had a goal of $1 million that they hope to hit by the end of the year, and they currently sit at $450,000. That's less than halfway there with just 5 days left in the year. Now, they usually generate a third of their annual funding during the holiday season, and they're pretty far behind. They use that money for several programs that help people, thousands of people. Their executive director, Major Butch Frost, he told me today that, quite frankly, they're getting nervous.
We don't want to affect any of our programs, and we don't want to affect any of our staff. We have good people working here, and the impact that they're making makes an impact upon the community, and there's change taking place.
Well, Jesse, the Salvation Army has been around for a long time, but right. A lot of people aren't aware of what exactly it is that they do specifically.
Yeah. They have a lot of programs. What are some of those programs and services that they provide to the community?
Right, guys. Well, just today when we were there for that interview, they were having their after-school program. You might say to yourself, well, school is out right now. Mm-hmm. So they've actually opened themselves up to be almost a full daycare, open from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m., so huge for parents that are working with, you know, small children over Christmas break here.
Absolutely.
They also have a couple different shelters, actually maybe three or four. They have one just for women and children, then one for men. We visited that shelter today. 31 homeless men that are working towards getting on their feet and getting a job and a home, so a big need right now for funding to help thousands of people who rely on their services.
For sure.
Jesse, 5 days
thank
left.
You.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, yeah. Jesse.
To donate, you can visit their website or check out the link to the story on our website, OzarksFirst.com.